Hey guys, how's it going? It's me, Ashwath Srivatsan, and welcome back to On the Same Wavelength, where we're going to be talking about last week in science. Anyways, let's get right on to it. Starting off in space, a NASA study explores dramatically cutting the cost of human expedition to Mars by putting the astronauts into a deep sleep called torpor that would use existing medical procedures to reduce astronauts' metabolic functions. That's pretty interesting overall. So another advancement in space travel. Of course, we've always reasoned that the basic way of moving people throughout space would have to be some form of cryostasis or deliberately induced coma, sleep, something like that, to use less supplies, and obviously because the trip would take such a long period of time. So it's very interesting that we found current medical procedures that we can utilize for this process. In energy, a team has successfully combined a battery and a solar cell into a hybrid device using a mesh solar panel. The team believes that their device could bring down solar energy costs by 25%. So, as you may or may not know, solar panels themselves are very expensive to set up, actually. And they're very expensive to maintain, and while in the end, the energy efficiency outweighs that cost, that takes quite some time to do. So the fact that we've managed to find a more efficient way to create solar energy is very, very interesting. Moving on into materials, researchers have synthesized a material that can bind and store oxygen in high concentrations, with a bucketful being enough to absorb all the oxygen in a room. The stored oxygen can be released again when and where it is needed. So compressed oxygen is needed in quite a few situations, diving, space travel, pressurized oxygen is used in multiple situations also, along with, I know this is a very basic one, but like the little blow things that you can get to clean out your keyboards, but stuff like that. So finding a synthesized material that can store oxygen so effectively is a really cool development. Moving back into space for a minute here, scientists have discovered a giant rectangle thought to be the remnants of a geological plumbing system that spilled lava across the moon about 3.5 billion years ago. Before you get your hopes up, this is not an alien formation in the sense that it was created by extraterrestrials. It's the remains of a geological plumbing system, meaning that this is something that had already existed. We didn't just find the remains of Martians, don't get your hopes up about that. At least not yet. Moving into physics, scientists have designed a record-breaking laser that accelerates the interaction between light and matter by 10 times and could ultimately lead to faster data connection speeds. I mean, what else is there to say about that? Data connection is something huge. I mean, we're all already so frustrated whenever our internet connection goes out by just the shortest bit, or if we get any bit of lag. So moving into this faster, more instant world is something that we really need to do, and this process that physicists have recently discovered is a step closer to doing that. And finally, moving into medicine, a 36-year-old Swedish woman has become the world's first woman, in fact, to give birth after receiving a womb transplant, with the success being viewed as a breakthrough for infertile women. That one's pretty self-explanatory, there's not much to say about that, but we're making progress in every aspect of science, every single week, and I urge you guys to continue following me talking about this, or continue looking up the articles on your own, because everything we're doing is so fascinating, and we're making these huge leaps and bounds in technology and science that we previously would have thought, like, unreachable, and it's so interesting how quickly this is all happening. Anyways, I really appreciate you guys sticking around for this, and let's move on into the word/phrase of the week and the song of the week. The word of the week, this week around, is... Our word of the week for this week is going to be fulgent. Fulgent is a word that doesn't sound exactly appealing, but actually means dazzlingly bright or radiant. Surprising, given the sound of the word, because when I first heard it, I thought it would be maybe somewhat not so shiny and brilliant, but it means dazzlingly bright or radiant, And that's going to be our word of the week. Our song of the week for this week is going to be by Passenger. It's not When You Let Her Go, which is his most common song. It's going to be Life's for the Living, which is one of my favorite songs by Passenger. I like it a lot more than I like When You Let Her Go, so stick around for that. And in the meantime, before we get to that, I'd just like to say, thank you so much for dropping by and listening to this week's episode of On the Same Wavelength when we talked about science. I really appreciate it. Be sure to show your appreciation in some form, whether you like the video, subscribe, or show it to a friend. And I would totally appreciate it if you could slap that like button, leave a comment, or tell me what you want to see next. I'll see you guys in the next episode of whatever that may be, and don't forget to live long and peace out. Bye!
Well, great clouds wrapped round the town like elastic. Cars stood like toys made of Taiwanese plastic. The boy laughed at the spastic, dancing around in the rain. While laundrettes clean clothes, high heels rub toes. Puddles splashed huddles of bus stop crows. Dressed in their suits and their boots, where they all look the same. Took myself down to the cafe to find all the boys lost in books and crackling vinyl, and carved out a poem above the urinal, the red. Don't you cry for the lost, smile for the living. Get what you need and give what you're given. Life's for the living, so live it, or you're better off dead. While the evening pulled the moon out of its packet, stars shone like buttons on an old man's jacket. We needed a nail, but we tacked it till it fell off the wall. While pigeons pecked trains, sparks flew like planes. The rain showed the rainbows in the oil stains. When we all had new iPhones, but no one had no one to call. Stumble down to the stomach of the town, where the widow takes memories to slowly drown. With a hand to the sky and a mist in her eyes, she said, don't you cry for the lost, smile for the living. Get what you need and give what you're given. Life's for the living, so live it, or you're better off dead. Leaves and a blanket of stars, and I stitch the words into my dead. Don't you cry for the lost, smile for the living. Get what you need and give what you're given. Life's for the living, so live it, or you're better off dead.